Which is more popular, Sun or Moon? Probably Moon.
Probably Moon is more popular. I remember when people were polled about it online, people gravitated towards Moon more. I know that Moon was what I wanted because, I mean, a lot of my old nicknames used to include Moon. Shelly Moon.
Yep.
Fun stuff, but...
Let's see.
Also Lunala.
To quote, I've been debating on getting the Switch just for this game. Would I recommend it? This is the most expensive game I've ever gotten. It cost me, what, 360? Well, no, throwing the Amiibos. It's about 400 bucks to play Breath of the Wild. Worth every penny. Okay, so we got a tower over there. We got a shrine there. Is it that tower? Oh, no, it's probably that tower.
I mean, it is extensive. Uh-oh.
Are you...
It's gonna... Yeah, unless you drop, it's gonna blast you out of the sky. Oh, and there's more of them? They're embedded in the ground. Is there any way to avoid that? Whoa!
I would recommend mainly running.
A ton of skeletons, too. It would be cool if it destroyed them behind you.
That'd be great.
Hate okay. Those robots.
There we go. Line of sight. Does the trick. At some point, I'll kill him.
Keese.
But for now, don't feel like it. Okay. So we're heading for that tower. Good. Because I've been wanting to come over here for a long time because I want to go Korok farming. And there's only so many in, like, certain areas. So by... Oh, hello.
Urbosa's fury is ready.
Now that I think about it, I've always gotten the colder colored Pokemon games. Because my first one was blue. The second one that I played was silver. And I know this sounds bad, but I never ended up getting a Game Boy Advanced, Game Boy DS. It wasn't until the 3DS that we actually got a new system, a new handheld system.
Yep.
I think it's because my parents were a bit more reserved when it came to computer.
Well, your parents also don't even understand why people play video games, from what I can tell.
Well, actually, I mean, my dad understands. He likes playing the occasional video game. Well, he's changed. But it's... I think they were perplexed by the fact that people enjoyed watching others play video games.
I mean, I can kind of understand that.
And I mean, I enjoy watching you because I don't have the stress of being at the controls. But I sometimes miss being at the controls sometimes. But it's something, it's a way for us to experience the games together because otherwise, unless you're playing a multiplayer game, video games are pretty solitary. But then again, reading a book is solitary unless you're with others. Watching a movie or a television series is quite solitary. I perceive video games as another medium to get narrative across.
This is probably the easiest Hinox I've ever fought.
Whoa, how are you electrocuting him?
He's got a metal bracelet.
Oh. And it actually reacts?
Haha, we're at the diggle.
I don't want to see that.
Too late. You saw it. Now you must pay the price. Oops, missed.
Whoa, what's that on that, like, fold of skin?
He's...
like, next to the diaper. I mean, it's just clipping through, right?
Yeah, probably. That was quite possibly the easiest Hinox fight I have ever gone through. Bar none. It was amazing. Roasted whole bird.
A whole bird.
Hinox toenail.
Ooh, guts.
I think I need Hinox guts.
I hear a tingling. Aw.
Yeah, no idea.
I thought it was a fairy or something, but...
Well, I mean, if I'm looking for fairies, we go elsewhere. I've got, like, a bunch of them. That tingling is, thunder. Whoop. Oh, I can't wait for this.
Did you ever get the, skeletons? I thought at night you were supposed to wear those. Okay.
What about getting the skeletons?
I thought that you had the camouflage armor that prevented them from attacking you.
If I put it on.
Will you?
Eh. I think you also have to upgrade that first. I could be wrong. What are you so worried about?
Oh, you're wearing the helmet now, so it doesn't affect you.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm having a good time here. All right. let's see.
Oh.
I call them fox snacks.
And it set the grass ablaze, which gave you a little boost.
Yep. Probably could have stuck around there just for a moment.
Oh wait, was that a ring of rocks underwater?
Might have been. It might have been one of those where you have to land in the center.
Mm.
I wasn't paying full attention. I'll pay more attention later. The thing about like Koroks is I can do that off camera. Or as like separate streams entirely.
My thing about Koroks, though, is you might not remember to come back. Unless you do one of your tags.
Well, I have a map. With every...
How do you keep track of the ones that you've already been to, though?
Have they noticed me? They've noticed me. Well, I'm wearing the exact wrong armor for this. Time to put the metal stuff back on! Let's see. I had a good helmet, didn't I? Oh, right. We want that helmet. Ah! All right.
The fiesta music, still.
Learn to love the fiesta. Let's go, Sora Sword. Hey.
My stomach's starting to hurt. I'm gonna have to get some kind of snacky.
Well, we could also stop soon. I just want to get to this tower.
That's only 121. Or what do you intend to do afterwards?
Well, there's actually a new Zelda-like that came out recently.
A Zelda-like? How is it Zelda-like?
It's like Blossom Princess and the Dragon King or something silly like that.
Really?
It's like old school, like, top-down Zelda.
Blossom Princess.
I think that's the case.
Okay.
I was not exactly paying full attention to the name. It looked neat, and I've kind of wanted to play it. Or I could just stop, because I'm getting that, like, kind of pain behind my eyes tiredness. Which is usually a good sign of go to bed, Wanderbot. It's bedtime. You can film more stuff tomorrow.
I have to get my next video up, but I have 30 clips? A feathered spear.
Its lightweight design is a hallmark of Rito craftsmanship. It's made from light and sturdy materials, which afford Rito warriors ease of use during aerial combat.
Hmm.
Your inventory's full. There we go.
Oh wow, those are metal crates.
Yep.
I didn't know that you could hack them apart.
If you have a club big enough, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is a... Let's see if I can lightning them apart. The answer is yes. Probably shouldn't have done that, though.
Oh, did it completely incinerate anything that you would have gotten?
It didn't incinerate it, just sends it flying.
Oh.
Yeah. Kind of inconvenient. I mean, realistically, I don't need any of these things. Oh. Dazza Korok.
Oh. Is it the one where it's like 1, 2, 3?
Shoot.
Where'd it go?
Normally, I listen for it.
But because there's so much rain in the zapping. I really don't like thunderstorms in this game.
I don't mind it now that we have the thunder helm. Like, it doesn't bug me so much.
Oh, it's leading up there. Better have the stamina for it.
I mean, even if I don't have the... Even if I don't have the stamina, I got plenty of stamina food, from what I remember.
Whoa, what are those noises?
Yeah, I don't know.
Some kind of creature living up there?
Might be something. Oh.
Oh, it's over there. You're gonna need to eat some kind of stamina saving. You have to. There's no other grip.
Well.
Well, you're by the bottom anyway.
Can I just shoot it?
Or do you have to touch it with your body?
Probably have to touch it with my body. Wait, hold on. I want to try something. Did I ever try... Have I ever tried getting a speed boost going into one of these?
A speed boost and stamina boost would be nice.
Well, can't do a speed boost, I think. Wait, unless that's it. No, that's electricity.
Well, oh. Wait, there's a stamina booster.
Well, yeah, but I don't want to do stamina boosters. I prefer stamina recoveries, because that's usually a lot cheaper on the resources. Well, luckily it doesn't seem to go away, which is kind of nice.
Now, what is that meter? The pink.
What, the elephant on
no,
the left?
No, down to the right.
Oh, that's how much noise I'm making.
Oh, interesting.
Yep.
I mean, I've never really seen you employ stealth before, so...
I don't use it that often.
What is living up there? Also, you need to eat something.
Unfortunately, yeah, it started raining again.
Oh, you're sliding.
This is kind of the exact worst.
Rain, go away!
Hi! I'm here now! Oh god!
They've... Okay. They all fire arrows?
Was not entirely expecting fire-based death. Okay. Okay, well, if we're lucky... Okay, don't drop your stuff, thank you. There's another one, okay. Yeah, these are the dangerous ones.
That's because they have the...
There we go. And they got the fire arrows.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of rare.
Whoa, he tumbled.
Yeah, you hit a moblin with a club and they go flying.
Well, more it's just that he spun around at least two times in midair.
It's super satisfying. Okay, so we got that there. It's raining. Honestly, I kind of want to just leave this Korok.
But you probably only have one or two more to go. Like, can you find the point where it is, though? That'd be easier. Yeah, the flower's over there.
We should put on the climbing gear no matter what. This might deplete, like, all of my food, though. Well, it could be worse.
Can you even hang upside down? It doesn't... You won't be able to do it.
I'm just... Well,
unless you jump off the side and then glide your
way. I'm gonna try climbing down, but if you notice, it's about to stop raining.
No, I think it's gonna be too sheer and you're gonna fall. I think you have to jump off with a glider and, maybe? If you touch it with your feet, okay. Oh.
What the fuck, Korok? This better give me multiple seeds, it's only gonna give me one. Jerk. Okay. Let's get down here. I think I'm gonna have English muffins for late night dinner.
Mmm, sounds good.
I've been having them with butter lately. Just basic English muffin and butter.
Oh! Yeah. Hi, you found me! And you have a Korok seed, bye-bye!
Yeah, there's another Korok thing there.
Yeah, that I can chuck. It looked like some stones.
Yeah, some stones that you chuck a rock into. I'll do that later. I'm really... At this point, now that I have enough inventory space to not have to worry about it...
Do I want to go to that tower?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's been my plan all along.
What we got... Oh. Because they were sticking out that way, protruding.
Mm-hmm.
They really tried to fortify their location.
They did.
I mean, it makes sense. When they're on a bridge, it means that there's only two avenues for someone to approach them.
Three if you count from below!
They didn't anticipate that.
I really like exploring this game. I really hope other games try and kind of emulate this. If that makes sense. Like, I'm really impressed with the exploration, the travel, the movement, and so on and so forth. Oh, dude, you can actually see the storm coming in.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome.
Horses.
Yeah, we don't really need a horse right now, though.
Well, that's because you have a pony.
If I had a musical instrument that I could...
Whoa! A bunch of chews.
If I had a musical instrument where I could summon my horse to wherever my location is, I would be so totally down with summoning a pony all the time. But as it stands, it's just like... I have... no time or interest in what the heck is that? Alright, we're gonna go check that out.
Okay.
Whatever that is.
Odd-looking rock?
Yeah, exactly. We're also gonna freak out a bunch of horses. Eh. Yeah. 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 I'm the Link. I'm coming.
That doesn't sound right.
It's okay.
Oh, hey!
Oh, it's Korok.
You have to lift it.
Yeah, yeah. Oh.
Or you have to stasis it and then chuck it.
Huh. Well, that should work.
Alright. Yeah, you found me! Whee!
You.
You missed.
Eh, happens. They will say, like, ow, if you hit them in the face.
Really?
Yeah.
Aw.
It's great.
Oh, hey, it's another herd. Off to the left. And I also heard the squeal of fox.
Yep. I mean, there's a herd of horses. You're not wrong. It's just a matter of, like, I'm going to be climbing in... within a minute.
Ooh, look at those.
What?
Are those...
rocks? The clouds?
Mushrooms or rocks that have been eroded away to the point where they look like
mushrooms? They're like mushroomy things.
I love massive mushrooms.
I have no weapon. Let's fix that.
Especially when they're bioluminescent.
Oh, dude. Bioluminescent mushrooms are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
There needs to be more of them in games.
I mean, let's see. I remember there was a whole age dedicated them to them in Mist. Uru. It was...
This is the mushroom age. We use it for cooking.
I think it was called, like, Teladon. Uh-oh. Gonna be able to fly over there? You're gonna run up the hill, aren't you?
I'm gonna fly as far as I can, and then I'm gonna run up the hill. It'd be great
and
if-
And then, I mean, there's Felucia in the Star Wars universe. Except who- Yeah, it's canon because it was in the movies.
We got it.
Great.
Just barely, but we got it.
Yeah, Korok seed. Okay.
Onwards. I guess we might as well just go across here. Yeah.
Why? You didn't even need the clip.
Is it getting cold? It's not too cold. Okay, I can definitely climb this. I really wish, like, you could get, like, climbing equipment, some other accessories in this game. I still really like this game. You know, I still agree with the people. I agree with the people, you know, that say they really love this game. But man, I'm missing the accessory system, kind of, from the previous Zelda games. You know, the hookshot, the...
Oh, you mean how you acquired a new weapon in every dungeon, and like, it was a permanent...
I'm really happy with upgrading my armor, and so on and so forth.
Because in Twilight Princess, the things that you acquired would help you get hearts in the open world.
Yeah. And, like, I would really like it if we were constantly finding, like, bits and bobs and cool little doodads.
Oh, wow, this is surrounded by the little, the mages, right? But these are the of the lightning variety? Right?
Yeah. Should be okay.
Oh, oh, and he even has electric arrows or lightning arrows.
Aha! Let me slap you around with this sword.
Bounced right off. Wow.
Man, you have a crappy bow. Okay, so we actually are gonna kill these guys. I know you're not entirely
well,
down for
otherwise
farming.
They would fire upon you.
No, they don't have exactly the most aggressive of range. It's mainly we desperately need we desperately need as many Lazalfos anythings as possible.
Okay, why
to,
is that?
To upgrade our Zora armor.
Oh.
Like we need I want to say it's like just pure Lazal, like everything. It's talons, horns, or whatever. I don't know. I kind of forget.
What's that sticking up out of the ground?
Fish?
Spears?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, are they... They're conversing. Gesticulating
loudly. They're fighting over their food.
Loudly.
Yeah, so then they go for their spears. Yoink.
He's still angry about the fish.
He hit me with his tail. That's not okay. Oh!
Oh, and he just picked up the spit.
Well, good dodging on his part. I guess let's just use the Master Sword. It does kind of destroy them faster. At least we barely take damage from anything.
Well, doesn't it get sustained damage this way? Or because it's not the nightmare creatures? Ooh, there's the castle. This is probably... Not the closest we've ever been to it, but fairly close.
One of the best views we've ever had. And, we were a little bit closer earlier when we were on the other side of the bridge. Jesus. Wow, look at him
he's
go.
Fast.
Can I be a Lazalfos? Like, I'd have no trouble going over land.
Well, apparently he's stuck somewhere. Oh. Oh, he was picking up another spear?
No, I think he was just stuck because he forgot we existed for a moment. They kind of do that. Lazalfoses are, dumb.
Oh, what's that in the water?
Lazalfos.
Okay.
This is not an easy tower to get to.
Yep.
Pachoo. This actually does a fair amount of damage.
Okay, and it's thundering again. Why does it rain so often? Or is it only in certain regions?
Did that get him? Aha! Good stuff. All right, let's
put on
our... So
there is floating debris.
Zora armor. Yeah, well, the floating debris is all of his stuff.
No.
Oh.
There's stuff floating that you can stand on. Also, more of the mushroom, like, formations. It noticed you then.
Not too worried about it. I'm more worried.
The guy on the right. Yeah, oh, whoa, and he's a thunder horn, too. Does that mean he's magic based? He's firing stuff at you?
Probably wants to.
Yeah, get behind this. Then you'll have to defend your position.
Unfortunately, it's raining.
Oh.
Please make it so I don't slip down the tower.
Those are pretty good handholds by the looks of it.
Yeah, so we might not actually slip down. Awesome.
I'm surprised that they haven't used their range attacks to shoot you down, but I suppose it works.
Yeah. Either they totally suck or they totally suck. And I'm okay with either. All right, let's get up here and then take off everything of ours that's metal. I'm just gonna go quick here. Because if I don't have anything on, then we don't have to worry about lightning and we're good.
Oh, that's actually funny. I never noticed it before, but he's actually wearing the harness.
Oh, yeah. It's kind of meaningless.
Especially because you don't use carabiners.
Yeah, exactly.
But
we do have it.
I remember for a summer camp, I did rock ventures. It's where you just got to use the interior climbing walls all the time.
And my brother, well, my brother doesn't do rock ventures. My brother does, like, legit rock climbing.
Yeah.
I could never do it, though. It's murder on the fingers.
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't want to ruin my hands that way. I mean, for you, you need to play your video games. That yeah. requires your hands.
Oh, hold on.
I'm an artist, so I have to make sure that I preserve the use of my hands.
Looks like this tower is going to have some pretty good views.
I mean, what occupations can people do without hands?
I mean, there's a lot of, like, basic data entry that you could do very lightly.
Hmm. And probably, they probably have things that are able to write for you, right?
Yeah, well, you could do, text, speech to text.
Sheikah Tower activated.
So, like, there's a lot of things that you can do. Oh, dude, one of the guys was following me up the tower.
Yeah, I noticed him. Wait, what do you mean by one of the guys? No, I thought there was just a
No, one of the mages was stuck up, partway up the tower.
Scanning area.
You totally missed him, but he was just standing on one of the platforms. Mid, like, weird dance step. He was still aggroed on us.
Stalfos?
No.
No, it's not Stalfos. Lizalfos?
No, the wizards.
Oh, the interesting. I still call them, like, Poish, but they're not quite Poish. People call them Wizlow or Wiz some things.
Wizalfos.
Huh? Wizalfos.
Making it dumb.
Okay, who's this guy?
It's quite high. Only I was a bird man. Boo! Ah! Where'd you come from? Don't scare me like that. How did you get up here? I just thought you'd ask, you could ask me the same question. You see, I've just dedicated my life to the study of birdmen. Their flight mechanics fascinate me. Given their weight, it should be physically impossible for them to fly with wings their size. I just don't get it. I was standing on the ground watching the skies when suddenly this tower erupted beneath my feet. I've been stuck up here since with no way to get down. But my misfortune is a blessing in disguise. What is that? Oh, that's like the fringe on his shoulder. I thought he had like a weird curly Q coming out of his mouth. You see, this tower is the perfect place to observe birdmen in their natural habitat. Oh my, now that you've climbed up here, how will you get back down without falling? I suppose you're stuck here too. I'll just fly down. What? You can fly? You can fly like a birdman? Is it true? I thought it was impossible for a Hylian to fly like a birdman. That's more like gliding then. That's still a step in the right direction. If I can analyze your glide distance and trajectory, it may help us understand the science of the birdman flight. And maybe one day I'll realize my dream of becoming a bird! Would you mind participating in a short research study? I want to see how far you can glide. You'll be compensated for your time and travel, depending on how far you fly. So, how about it? Sure.
Ooh.
Marvelous. Well, our findings today may prove to be the cornerstone of birdmen research for generations to come. However, you're merely gliding, not flying, making this a rather dangerous research project. As such, a liability fee of 20 rupees will be necessary to proceed. You know, in case I have to file an incident report.
You mean to, like, the whole, like, do people even understand the concept of suing? In this sort of, like, medieval realm? I suppose.
Okay, so this guy's a flying minigame.
He is a flying minigame.
Okay, so we got that over there. Next one. Actually?
A liability fee, huh?
We're gonna get every tower. Ooh, there's the Rito thing.
The flying airship.
Oh, that's...
That's the bird.
That's the straight up bird.
Oh.
Was wondering about that. Because we saw it earlier and we thought it was like a village or something. Is that another one?
Looks like it. Now watch out. You no longer have your helmet on.
But I don't have anything metal on either.
Okay.
If you notice, I'm like completely without anything. I kind of wish I'd like punch.
Oh, you mean unarmed combat?
Yeah, just punch a fox. Give it a slug right in the... Right in the yipper. At the very least, I had...
Ooh, sparkly. Where are they?
Probably just basic iron ore. Oh, my claymores are gone.
All of them? How did that happen? Fighting?
Yeah. So, I was also using them for mining. And now that they're busted, they're nice. Hey,
there's another tower in the distance. Oh no, it is a key swarm. Would you call them a swarm or a flock? Given that they're bird-like, but also nefarious and evil.
Did I even get any of them?
Like, swarm just denotes vileness. But that's... It's preferable for insects to be called that, though.
Okay, got a couple of them. It's usually enough to get the keets to run away, I think. Yeah?
I wonder what a group of bats are called.
A guano? No? Worth a shot.
Guano. I find it's interesting that there's special words just for, like, the type of poop that one animal secretes.
I mean, it's, like, super sulfury and used for stuff.
That's true. It's also quite liquid, isn't it?
I have no idea.
It sort of dries and gloops. I don't know.
Well, I mean, imagine if you were a bat and you had, like, a solid turd knock you off course.
Oh, this just reminds me of Budapest when we went to the zoo and all the fruit bats, the poor things.
It's their own damn fault.
They had made their little enclosure in such a way that all of their roosting posts were angled on top of one another. So it's like they're all dangling from little racks made especially for bats, except the rats hung over one another. So when one bat had to go to the bathroom, he would just grip onto the pole, release his legs, and unfortunately he'd urinate on the person below him. Well, not person, the bat. It was just unfortunate. Colony of bats. Interesting.
Of course, we have more keets going around. Let's see, there they are. Well, now we've got a bunch of these, at the very least.
Monya Toma Shrine. Oh, another fox! What's up with you and murdering foxes?
I need food.
Yeah.
I need, like, lots of food. We take a lot of damage, and unlike regular Zelda games where you can just get hearts off of enemies, this one, you get hearts off of foxes!
And their sweet, succulent fox meat.